So we made everything you see here using just the contents of these two bottles and some paper that was already in a binder form. So it didn't take many ingredients to make this much potential art fun. And again, all of these papers are available for purchase at lightprintpaper.com. Depending on when you've watched this, different sizes may be available, but I intend to keep producing this paper because I'm making it for myself weekly. And I figure it's just as easy to make extra that I can then offer to the world so that everyone else can have the fun I'm having. Because I'm having a lot of fun with this. And in fact, that's a great segue into how we get to have fun with this. I'm gonna load up this paper and this paper and this paper. I'm gonna load up all this paper. And I'm gonna put it in this very ostentatious case, which is a portfolio that I got at a thrift store, and it's empty inside. And but this keeps all the paper light, tight, and safe. So that I can go out into the world and find interesting shadows. All right. So now we got this. Oh, well, look at this. This little guy decided he didn't want to join the party. That's okay. You be there. Here's our cyanotypes. Let's go have some fun in the world. I'm going to put on socks because I'm not wearing any, but I'm going to be ready to go after that. In fact, I'm going to go right now. And it is a loud environment, so I have switched to voiceover narration for this section of the video. We are taking out some paper from our portfolio, cyanotype paper specifically, and I'm gonna make a 16 by 20 size cyanotype to begin with. First, I'm covering up the part of the bench that is letting light through it, but with the portfolio, and I'm securing a piece of cyanotype paper behind it with a few magnets. And in just a moment, you'll see everywhere on the bench that is greenish yellow has a piece of cyanotype paper behind it. And it is currently being exposed to the sun. And I'm gonna take the camera off the tripod and give you a behind the scenes, literally behind this scene view of the cyanotype being made. As you can see, it's being held up with four magnets. Everywhere that you see right now that is yellow greenish will become dark blue in the final cyanotype. Everywhere that is black right now will remain unexposed, and therefore it will stay white in the finished cyanotype. And we will now put the camera back on the tripod and resume the time-lapse fun. I'm gonna make a few more of the 8.5 by 11 size cyanotypes, and I'm gonna make just some pattern blocks. Here, let's take a look at real quick the finished result of the undeveloped cyanotype we just made. So you can see it's basically like light graffiti. We just took some vandalism without destroying anything. And I'm gonna make a few more in this nice light, cyanotypes with the pattern blocks. And we're gonna flip around to the other bench. Even though this looks the same, technically it is going to emit, or it is gonna pass light differently than the other one because it is flipped 180 degrees from the way the other bench is oriented. So I can take a cyanotype I made on the other bench and apply it to this bench if it's a two-sided cyanotype. And then I'll get the same exposure on both sides and theoretically make a double-sided cyanotype that results in a very nice contact print. And I can also mix these pattern block cyanotypes down here on the ground. And when I'm done with that, I can go up to a lovely park that's just up the street. And here I am in the park that I just mentioned. I did another cyanotype of the bench because, I don't know, why not? Let's do a cyanotype of some of the little pricker balls that are everywhere, which is right there on the side. I'm using my portfolio to create some shade while I build it up. And then when I'm all done and I put everything on the cyanotype sheet, I'll remove the shade and let the cyanotype exposure begin. And I just found a couple more little balls that must be on there. And I'm working on the cyanotype with that little piece of branch there on the left on the bench. That is milkweed. I found a little sprig of it on my walk over here, so I decided to pick it up and bring it with me. And as you can see, I'm just using a binder clip to secure it, to secure the milkweed to the cyanotype paper, to the metal baking sheet. And I've just kind of wedged it into the bench there, so it'll be at the right angle for the shadow I want. And the basic gist of it is what you see. look around, see what might make a good shadow, put it on the cyanotype paper. And when you get home, or whenever you decide to develop these, you'll see what the results are. You can try to pre-visualize them as you go, but often the best results come from just seeing what happens when you try something. If you try too hard, you might actually be disappointed in the results. So, my recommendation is don't think, just try it. And when you're all done, pack everything up in your portfolio or your light type paper trap and take it on over to wherever your nearest water supply is. And I'll see you in the next video, part 3.